Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Good morning, my dear students. Today I will teach you the name of some food in Sanskrit. Bhojya Vastuni. Bhojya Vastuni means food. In the first line, first picture, Payasam. Payasam means kheer. Pa-ya-sa-yam. Payasam. Second picture, kshiram. Kshiram means milk. Kshi-ra-yam. Kshiram, milk. Third picture, chaya. Chaya means tea. Cha-ya. Chaya. Fourth picture, laddukam. La-id-du-ka-yam. Laddukam. Laddukam means laddu. Fifth picture, kundalikam. Ku-in-da-li-ka-yam. Kundalikam. Kundalikam means jangri. Sixth picture, lapsika. Lapsika means alwa. La-yip-si-ka. Lapsika. Alwa. Second line, first picture, rotika. Ro-ti-ka. Rotika. Rotika means chapati. Or roti. Rotika. Then second line, second picture, jambira rasaha. Ja yam bi ra ra saha. Jambira rasaha. Jambira rasaha means lemon juice. Then second line, third picture, pishtakam. Pi ish ta ka yam. Pishtakam. Pishtakam means biscuit. Then second line, fourth picture, cha ka le ha ha. Cha ka le ha ha. Cha ka le ha ha means chocolate. Then second line, fifth picture, nalika poopaha. Na li ka poopaha. Nalika poopaha. Nalika poopaha means wafer biscuit. Then second line, sixth picture, supishtakam. Su pi ish ta ka im. Supishtakam. Supishtakam means bread. Then the third line. See here, children. Third line, first picture, shalya poopaha. Shalya poopaha means idli. Sha il ya poopaha. Shalya poopaha. Idli. Then third line, second picture, apoopaha. Apoopaha means vada. Then the third picture, purika. 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 Purika means puri. Then third line, fourth picture, dosha. 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 Dosha means dosa. Then third line, fifth word, supishtaha. Supishtaha means Pongal. Su pi yish taha. Supishtaha. Pongal. Third line. Last picture. Tandulaha. Ta in du laha. Tandulaha. Rice. Tandulaha means rice. Children, I will read the words one by one. You repeat after me. Payasam. Kshiram. Chaya. Laddukam. Kundalikam. Lapsika. Rotika. Jambira rasaha. Pishtakam. Chakalehaha. Nalika poopaha. Supishtakam. Shalya poopaha. Apoopaha. Purika. Dosha. Supishtaha. Tandulaha. In this lesson, you can easily see all the three genders. In the first line, payasam, and the second word kshiram belongs to napumsakalingaha. Because the word ends with M pronunciation. Then the third word chaya, it belongs to strilingaha, feminine gender, because it's in the word ends with a. Then the fourth word and the fifth word laddukam, kundalikam, these two words belongs to napumsakalingaha. Then lapsika, it belongs to strilingaha, feminine gender. In the second line, the first word rotika, it belongs to strilingaha. Then the second word jambira rasaha. Jambira rasaha ends with aha pronunciation, so it belongs to pumlingaha. Then pishtakam. Pishtakam, the word pishtakam ends with im pronunciation, so it belongs to napumsakalingaha. Chakalehaha, it belongs to pumlingaha. Nalika poopaha, it belongs to masculine gender, pumlingaha. Then second line, last word supishtakam, the word ends with im pronunciation, it belongs to napumsakalingaha. Then in the third line, first word shalya poopaha, it belongs to masculine gender, pumlingaha. Then the second word apoopaha, it also belongs to pumlingaha, masculine gender. Then the next two words purika, dosha, these two words belongs to strilingaha. Then the last two words supishtaha, tandulaha, these two words belongs to pumlingaha, masculine gender. So children, you have to listen carefully. If a word ends with aha pronunciation or ihi pronunciation or uhu pronunciation, these words belongs to pumlingaha. If a word ends with a, e pronunciation, it belongs to strilingaha.